Believe me when I say that there was a time when we as designers only had to consider only the screen resolution of desktop computers when designing digital products. Nowadays, with all kinds of wearables, smartphones, laptops, tablets, and other tech, our job has become much more complicated. So how we can ensure scalability and adaptability of our interfaces? To handle that issue, designers came up with two primary approaches for designing across the diverse range of devices. Adaptive and responsive design. In the simplest terms, responsive design utilizes one layout and adjusts the content, navigation, and other elements of the interface to fit the user's screen. With a responsive design approach, you will create one flexible layout where all design elements will adapt to the resolution of the device that they will be viewed on. Desktop, tablet, mobile, and so on. Adaptive design, on the other hand, is all about creation of dedicated layouts for specific screen sizes. As opposed to more fluid, responsive approach, adaptive design employs multiple versions of our design. As you probably noticed, the adaptive approach will require a lot more work from you, because you will need to create dedicated layouts for a variety of resolutions or devices. It will require more work, not only from you, but from developers as well, because they will need to code for every separate resolution or device, in contrast to one flexible code, which would adjust the layout. You may now ask yourself, okay, so why I would add myself additional work with an adaptive approach instead of creating a flexible, responsive one? Well, it depends on the context of whatever you're designing for. Although adaptive design requires a lot more effort, it also allows you to create dedicated and more optimized experiences. With a responsive approach, you are essentially creating a set of rules that try to adapt your design to a wide variety of use cases, which sometimes may not be ideal. Right, so why should you use an adaptive design approach? Adaptive design is perfect for web apps that will have their individual releases on various platforms like iOS, Android, and desktop. Good examples for it are big web apps like Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and so on. Another situation where an adaptive approach is best for is retrofitting existing sites in order to make them more suitable for mobile phones. This allows you to take control of the design and development for specific multiple viewports. Responsive design doesn't offer as much control as adaptive, but takes much less work to build and maintain. It isn't a surprise then that the majority of websites and web apps nowadays are designed with a responsive approach. But what about fluid design? What's the difference? I would describe fluid design as a subsection of a responsive approach. With adaptive design, we are preparing dedicated screens, typically for 6 common screen widths. Based on the available screen real estate, user will get layout based on breakpoints that don't respond once they are loaded. With responsive design, we also can use 6 common screen widths as breakpoints, but our layout will populate and adapt to maximum available screen resolution. One of the prime examples of it is the 12-column layout, where you fit elements of your design in them. Columns correspond to the mentioned breakpoints, and elements of our interfaces shrink, expand, and rearrange based on the available space. Fluid design uses that principle, but instead of using defined pixel values, it deals with percentages in relation to other UI elements. So instead of container having defined size, dependent from a given breakpoint, it has percentage value in relation to other elements. In one of my next videos, I will come back and show you how it works from a more practical perspective. So if you are interested, hit like and subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn something else today, watch this video next. To the next time!